Welcome back to Weekend Chats with Mac. First and foremost, I would like to take this opportunity to apologize for leaving for so long. It wasn't my intention. You know, a lot happened in 2021, and if I'm keeping it real, I fell out of love with content creating. I felt like I lost my ability to tell my stories, and so I needed a break to recollect myself. But like, I believe I'm better now and I'm more vocal, and we are back, baby. Think I'm jumping out the window, how I got them open. Line around the corner, line them up, the block and over. Sometimes I even stop the smoking when it's time to focus. My shade, Dior, my pants, velour. Create, explore, expand, concord. I came, I saw, I came, I saw, I prayed. Oh my God, you guys have no idea how long I have been waiting to get back behind the mic. Shout out to you guys, man, for keeping it real with me. Shout out to everybody that's been DMing me, asking me to get back on this, because I really wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for you guys. Your support has been my biggest influence in me making this decision to come back. And again, dog, like, I feel like, yeah, it's time. 2022 is literally our year to just bring it to the universe and manifest good things. But anyway, that's besides why we are here today. So have you found yourself in a position where you are confused by your partner's behavior? You're confused by somebody you're talking to? You're confused by somebody you're trying to pursue something romantic with? In the sense that one minute they say this, that they love you, they want to be with you, they want to take you out, they want to do all sorts of things. And then in the next minute, they are so cold, they're distant. You know, basically what I'm saying is that their words aren't consistent with their actions, you know. If your answer is yes, then just know that you are in it. You are in those mind games that I'm here asking you about. Now, what are mind games in a relationship? Well, basically mind games are psychological tactics used by someone to manipulate or intimidate another person, you know. People often play these mind games as a way to avoid taking responsibility for their actions and feelings. So some examples of, you know, mind games in relationships may include playing hard to get, being mean for no reason, leading somebody on, or having that controlling attitude. So like, if these signs sound familiar to you and you want to know how to tell if someone is playing mind games with you, then sis, bro, continue listening to this podcast, because in a bit I'm gonna tell you guys reasons why people play mind games, and again to give you those signs that you should look out for in a relationship. Call it how it is. Hedges. I promise I swear, Yo. Mind you, when I say relationship, I don't mean just romantic relationships, but I'm talking about any form of relationship you can have with people around you, whether it's romantic, whether it's platonic, whether it's blood relations, then any form of relationship that you can have with a person, that is what I'm talking about. Mind games are always somewhere. There's something. But one thing that I can never wrap my head around is, why do people prefer taking the long route instead of the short route? Because when a person plays a mind game, it's definitely because they're trying to get something out of you. And instead of being straight, they choose to play around. Dog. It's 2022. Why are we still wasting each other's fucking time? But anyway, let me get straight into it. You know, the first reason why people play mind games is because they want something. I'm sure this one we can all agree. But the main reason here is that they want something. You know, people who play mind games want a specific response from their partner or the people around them. However, instead of saying or, you know, politely requesting by telling that person exactly what it is they want. They just choose to do what? To go through manipulative acts. You know, they just choose to go through the long route to attain that. But why should it be like that? You know, they relish playing games with emotions rather than speaking out. Come on, dog. Like I said, it's 2022. Let's be straight. Let's be intentional. If there's something that you want from somebody, say it straight. No, let's just be straight. You know, an example of what I'm talking about here is what? Basically jealousy, right? I want somebody and I'm not being truthful to the person that, you know what, I want you to be mine. And yet when I see somebody else doing something that I want to be doing for that person, I start telling this person, oh, so now you got somebody else. Yeah. Instead of being frank, you know what, love, I want you, I want to do all of these things for you. Get someone like you, pika pika kamonwana. Hey, get someone like you, pika kamonwana. Kira dilo tsotlhe tse instead of being straight. Gore, love, I want you. Kana bro, come on, let's not do that. Let's not do that, guys. It's 2022. Another reason why people may play mind games is because they're trying to manipulate you. I don't know if you guys were paying attention to, I don't know which episode it was, but I was talking about fake friends. These people basically come into your life. They try to extort a lot of things out of you. And after they get everything that they want from you, they just leave you, you know. So they manipulate you just so they can get something out of you. After they get what they want, they leave. So these people who play mind games do so to manipulate you into doing something for them. Some of the needs that they may be after, maybe money, love, care, sex, partnership, friendship, or to boost their self-esteem. I remember there's this conversation that is always had on Twitter. Yahore, gents, Gante, why can't we be frank? Hore, baby girl, I just want to have sex with you. I went, there's someone lari pika pika mwere, rebalala the girls, hore, eh, I love you. I want to marry you. We should have 4 kids. There's someone lari mwere, it's okay. Instead of being straight, hore, love, I'm sexually attracted to you or physically attracted to you, and I don't think there are high chances that I would want to pursue anything further than that. But again, Lauren, it's a controversial topic or a discussion that will be held another day. A girl where I'm just physically attracted to you, get a baby girl. I want to have sex with you. Getting a frank and honest, and she says no, not making kids or then definitely the best way for me to go about it is to do what? It's to manipulate. I mean, I'm not for it, but like I'm saying, sometimes I understand why guys choose to manipulate instead of being honest, but it's not a good thing, guys. It's 2022 again. Let's be intentional. I might sound a bit hypocritical at the moment, but like guys, it's not easy. It's not easy telling the truth sometimes, but we just have to, Niggas like me will simply tell the truth, whether it hurts you or not. I'll simply tell the truth. Mihela, you know what? Let me just leave that, But anyway, another reason why people might choose to be manipulative is that they just simply like being in control. You know, the whole essence of playing mind games is to be in charge of other people. So people who play mind games desire to have someone they can control and command around. Simply as that, because, you know, the alpha position gives them some adrenaline, reassuring them that they have power. It gives them the confidence and self-esteem, thus consistently show signs of mind control to see other position. And I'm sure you guys can agree with literally everything that I just said, where people always want to feel in control as a way to stroke their egos, or rather feel in control or feel as though they have the power to influence you into doing something, you know. So that is literally why people play mind control games. One other reason that is there is that they like to make others feel weak. Yeah, literally, that's literally that. So one person may ask, why do people play mind games? There's literally no other reason for people to play mind games other than to make people feel weak. Because at the end of it all, if I'm in control, then the other person has to be what? Has to be submissive to the whole thing, which means that whatever I say flies. And when I, as the person that is being, or when I, as the victim, you end up what? You end up doing literally anything that I ask you to do. And to me, it's probably my fetish. It's probably my fetish, or it's something that I enjoy seeing, where people listen to literally anything that I say. I feel in control, you feel weak, and I like to see you feel that way. You know, I like to see you feel that way. And yeah, it's literally fulfilling. So to them, it is a challenge where they alone become the winner. Basically. Meanwhile, these signs of mind control in a relationship come from low self-esteem and cowardness, you know. Instead of solving these problems, they would project them onto others. Motate in killing anale low self-esteem, they aren't confident about themselves, and so they just try to use others to stroke their own egos and project. At this point in time, if I'm to mention names, it would be chaotic. So for the sake of peace, I'm sure you guys listening to this, you are most likely name dropping somebody, or there's somebody that comes to mind as I say all of these things. And I'm sure at some point you've said to one of your friends, this guy likes to, this guy thinks he's smart, he does 1, 2, 3, and yet when I do that, they always complain, blah, blah, blah. The moment you say things like these, it shows you that you have already fallen prey into these mind games. And it's always a sticky situation. It's always a sticky situation to get out of. But it's literally that easy. But anyway, another reason why people play mind games may be the fact that the person that's playing these games mostly needs to feel important. They have that need to feel important. You know, closely related to one of the signs of mind games in a relationship is playing hard to get, like I mentioned earlier. That usually happens in those romantic relationships, where the people with these signs want to feel unique and essential to you. So as such, they end up sending you mixed signals to confuse you so that you can be persistent. You know, because I get like, itsogare banyana ba rata diputso tsa bo kantenera wa thawi. Well, ba rata tso diputso tso tsa bo wa thawi. Rena majita, we really don't like that question, but the fact that you are asking what are we, it is quite evident that the person you're asking has no intentions of being frank with you and has no intentions of being intentional. They are taking you on a ride. But you're literally on a ride. And the only way for you to get out of the ride is if you leave. This question, yeah, what are we, when somebody has shown you many times, you are just two people living on earth. Plenty of times, Motosalaho wants that, you're just people living on earth. In 2022, you guys are funny characters for real, man. Like, it is sad to see. It is really, really sad to see. But it is vital to be well acquainted with typical symptoms of mind control, guys. You know, the manipulations people use in relationships. But here it is. Let me give you the science of mind games in relationships. One, they confuse you. Literally, nothing they do or say ever makes sense to you, you know. Because people who play mind games in relationship, they leave you doubting the relationship and their feelings. They leave you doubting their feelings because at the end of it all, you end up questioning, Kante, does this person love me? Kante, does this person this, that? You know, the fact that you're questioning their intentions, their feelings, shows you that you're here. You're there. You're already there. Kore, we're in, inside, you know. You doubt yourself around them. You start to lose that confidence. Nyana, kore kante wenem. Am I the person this person wants to be with? Am I enough for this person? Wait, my sister, my bro. You're in it. You are in it. So at the moment these thoughts start to occur, just know that something is definitely wrong and you just need to sit down and introspect. Another thing that they may do is that they blame you all the time. It's always your fault, basically. Anything that they do, it's always your fault. If I cheat, it's your fault. If you catch me cheating, it's your fault. You know, it is never my fault. Anything that I do wrong is never my fault. It is always who? You. Anything wrong that I do, if I go to sleep and I don't text you good night, it's your fault. If I don't eat kolapeng, it's your fault. If my dad abandons me, it's your fault. You know, literally everything is your fault. And never do we ever want to take accountability or responsibility for our actions and how we made the other person feel. Another sign may be that they intentionally hurt you. You know, as strange as it may sound, some people really relish making others feel bad. Like I did mention earlier about them wanting to make you feel weak, maybe as a reason as to why people play mind games. So some people really enjoy seeing others feel bad, and so they just do anything in their power to make sure that you're never happy, you're sad all the time. You know, they might shout at you for helping them even when they didn't ask for it. Also, they enjoy playing mind games by making rude comments about you and your friends. These are literally things that I've seen happen in that city called Gaps. These things happen all the time. Another sign may be that they use others against you. You know, you think your partner should have your back, but you'll be surprised by people who play mind games, really. After several unsuccessful attempts to make you feel bad, they turn others against you. Because I get it, you guys know. You guys know these things. You've seen them happen to you. And I'm sure some experiences are coming to mind when I mention these things. You know, they do this by engaging in conversations they know you hate with others. Things say, don't worry, I can say to you, I definitely know that you don't like this conversation. And yet, I start the topic around you with other people around, you know, so that, you know, you start to fume. And I enjoy seeing you fuming, literally. They tell people you're a liar. We tell out most of the time, these people envy you. They want to be you so bad that they'll go through all the channels necessary to make you feel weak or to make you feel little about yourself. When are we going to stop doing this to each other? When are we going to stop sabotaging each other? When are we going to stop manipulating each other? Like, if relationships can be soft, then what are you doing? Why are you in it to begin with? Guys, seek help. Stop it. Get help. Today. Stop it. Get help. Today. And then one other reason or one other sign that is there is that they continuously or constantly compare you to others. But parents do this a lot. I'm sure you guys have been experiencing this since you were kids, but parents do this a lot. kantwena masego ke mo sankotsa bo e hela jaaka bo mmata ba gago ba ihlile mo tshamka le wena mo strateng bone ba pasa wena wa masego ke mo sa tse bo street is lena mma nyatle le tlhabisa batsa di ditlhong. I'm sorry to say, but guys, let's really stop making others feel bad about themselves, because the moment these things happen, it's for therapy once. And therapy adur. It's for therapy once. If I'm being quite honest, it's just for therapy. I really don't know if people know this, but like I have been saying this whole time, people that play mind games in relationships make people feel sad, replaceable, worthless. And that's feelings that I wouldn't want anybody to feel at all. Now imagine there are many people out there that still find comfort in making people feel like this all the time. And those people need help. Those people need serious help. Therapy. I wonder if Botswana would ever look to implement some policies on mandatory therapy for people deemed worthy to go through it. Because really some people really need some serious help, serious interventions, you know. But for somebody to get out of these things, like if you find yourself in this loop, it's literally simple. Express yourself clearly, you know, and precisely explain how these people's actions make you feel. Because that's literally one thing that you need to do. Be more vocal, you know. Make sure that this person apologizes. And if they don't, it's for you to decide, what are you going to stay or are you going to leave? Because at the end of the day, again, people make the decision to stay or go. People make the decision to have these things happen to them sometimes. You may be aware of these things and still allow them to happen. You allow somebody to play with your heart. You allow somebody to toy with your emotions because you enjoy it. But I don't know. Like I said, you decide. But all in all, I'll just keep saying it's 2022. Let's be more vocal. Let's be more intentional. Let's speak up where we have to. Let's stop playing mind games with one another. Stop lying to one another. Let's be more frank. Because in this game of love, in this game of relationships, there's always a checkmate.
Shining moon.